So I'm here on behalf of my colleague that proposed this project and developed this idea. He couldn't come because there is a project meeting which is coincident with this CDIO conference. So I will try to do my best to explain the idea and how is it going. So basically the idea was to propose multinational undergraduate teamwork in the context of a capstone project. And so basically I'm describing what's been achieved on the end of phase one. So this is the outline of this presentation. So basically the motivations for this idea and for the project. So we know that there are new professional requirements. There is a tendency to globalize, to have multinational teams. Even the work organization is changing. And the dependency from technology is increasing. So basically this will be a driver for a demand for new skills. So be able to work within an international setting, be able to collaborate, to cooperate, and so on. And also to communicate in several languages. So these motivations were the principal reason why this project was proposed to European funding, okay? And it was approved. So basically it's a multinational project course unit in which we try to integrate skills, mostly technical, and also to promote teamwork and communication, but within an international setting, involving institutions from several countries, not only from a region or a country, but several countries. In this case, European countries. So basically the idea is to propose an interesting and challenging project and to have teams of students. So basically two students per institution, okay? Six institutions in each team, which accounts for approximately 6,000 man hours. To be as most possible modular, so that it can be decomposed in separate components and developed in each institution and then integrated and tested. Also to be an open specification, so a difficult and realistic thing to do with relevance and impact. So in the beginning, just to create the context and to prepare the students, the idea is to have some competence seminars, so basically to prepare the students for this completely different and more challenging experience, which emphasizes aspects related to communication and negotiation and intercultural communication, of course, and also some technical explanation about what is an open source, what are the legal implications of doing it open source, and so on. So this is a kind of preparation for the work. So basically, the proposal was divided into phases. The phase one was funded in the context of the Erasmus project from 2009 to 2011, as just finished. So the idea was to design, deploy, evaluate, experiment, change, and so on. And also to try to disseminate this to key actors in the European higher institutions. So phase two, which is now beginning, is to set a permanent course unit in the institutions which adhere to this kind of international project, which is the case of IZ. So the idea is to enlarge this consortium to include new institutions and also to provide complement common projects. So for instance, this year, in 2011-2012, the students for informatics engineering in my school can make the capstone project within the school, in an enterprise or a public institution in the region, or they can choose to do this multinational project with people from other institutions and other countries. So this is another aspect or not, different view of the capstone. So in the first phase, it was possible to gather 11 institutions from 9 countries, and the students were assembled into teams. So it ran for 2 years, so we had 4 editions of this experience. It involved 30 teachers from all the institutions, 44 students, and also it was important to include educational psychologists to do the monitoring of this experience, and to external evaluators, professional people with a background on evaluation. And it ran very, very nicely. It was quite challenging, as I said before. So basically, we had some problems. One problem was mainly logistic. It was in terms of matching the calendars between institutions, because throughout Europe, we don't start the curricular semesters at the same time. So this makes things a little difficult. But even so, it is possible to make arrangements, and it can work nicely. It is also necessary to have 3 or 4 days for this project in which the students cannot attend classes. Okay. And there is also the challenge of finding a project that is compatible with this approach. So after phase one has been identified as a success, now comes phase two, which is more challenging because there is no public fund, there is no European funding, so the institutions must find a model, business model for this, which of course makes possible to run this for several years without having deficits or spending too much money. So it has been estimated that to achieve financial sustainability within this project, we need per year something around 750 euros per student. So basically, we cannot be on Erasmus forever. So basically, we have to look for institution funds or from sponsorship from external stakeholders, enterprises, whatever. Okay. It is also important that we anticipate it is possible to gather internship proposals from interesting industry players, which may also guarantee the sustainability of the project. So basically, the quality of this first phase was evaluated from student feedback forms, peer evaluation, group work platform statistics, and feedbacks from seminars. So basically, just to give you some idea of the results, in terms of student feedback, so it was a consensus that this project improved teamwork skills, okay, and also improved communication skills in an international setting, with some particular aspects which are described in the slide. In terms of motivations, expectations, and satisfaction results, we list the main ones. So the motivations were academic, were in terms of learning another language, in terms of contributing to career planning, and to have an European experience. Okay. So basically, interesting motivations and results from this project. In terms of expectations and several dimensions, it is interesting to see that eventually the students were a bit optimistic. Probably they thought that if they participate in a project like this, it would be very easy to find a job, which is not true, of course. So basically, the results are very positive, but in terms of job expectations, it was too high for the students. So basically, having an international experience in project is important, but is not sufficient. In terms also of feedback from the students, we emphasize these aspects, resilience and enjoyment, These are also very understandable in terms of this project. So it was interesting to see that the students, after some initial learning curve in which there were some problems, rapidly converged to a situation of very good work and very good communication. In terms of suggestions, basically these were the most important ones. So, training skills for time management, because in Europe not all people has the same idea about time management, so it is important. Also, the shortage of skills for managing conflicts, which is something we must eventually try to address in the future, and increasing communication skills. So this second phase will be starting next September. It will gather several institutions from Portugal, Belgium, Scotland, Spain, and others. So basically, most of them come from the previous phase, and the new ones will be joining because the results were found attractive and interesting. So basically, this was an interesting idea. The first phase was challenging, but showed that the idea is sustainable. So now we have the challenge of the financial aspects. Okay? So it's not possible to run this on public funding forever. So we must find something that makes this sustainable on the long run. It also served some interesting purpose, like disseminating CDIO. So the idea is that we can see this as an opportunity for, like a vector for viral spread of the CDIO concept. So many of these institutions didn't know about CDIO, and now they know, and they are curious. So it is also interesting for us to disseminate CDIO concepts and ideas using this approach. So this is basically what I had to say about this project, and I'm open to your questions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any questions?
No, just a small remark. I mean, the undertaking of your project is overwhelming.
Yes.
Both in industrial concept, I very rarely heard about consortiums this size. The other thing I would like to encourage you to continue, we recently did the survey and we found out that 68% of our graduates are asked to travel abroad and communicate with foreigners to complete their engineering job. And the third point I'd like to do is to say is that we are trying to formulate a much smaller one-to-one, two students doing projects over the net, and if there are people in this room interested in following this, I'd be more than happy to consult. I congratulate you for succeeding in a project like this, which looks to me as a mission impossible.
We'll see in this second phase. But even so, it's interesting and important to emphasize that this was done within an informatics engineering in which we deal with software and computers. We have computers everywhere, so you can work here, work 100 kilometers from here. We are also trying to explore this idea in terms of electrical engineering. Perhaps it's not so easy because most of the times you need labs with some equipment and so on. But the idea seems possible. But it will be not as easy as informatics or computer science. But even so, it's a direction that we are trying to address. But the logistical problems perhaps will be much greater. But even so, we'll try to do it.
Any questions? I have one question. How do you evaluate the prior knowledge of the individual contributors to the project.
The prior knowledge.
The prior knowledge, so that you have defined a top level project requirements. You have those, but then you have to assign or get students involved that contribute the pertinent knowledge.
Yes.
How do you make sure that that is guaranteed?
So that is done by the teachers. So basically, the project is defined. It must be decomposable in blocks that can be done individually and later on integrated. And the teachers, one of the most important jobs for the teachers, tasks for the teacher, is to analyze and decide, okay, this module has some requisites. My students perhaps are not so strongly prepared to do this, and then they are. So it is important for the teachers to know their students and to identify if it is reasonable or not to have them working on a module. Because even though they are studying informatics or computer science, they are different from country to country. So it is important to make this balance correctly, or else the project goes down very quickly.
Do you have a student leader on this team, or is it faculty driven?
It has been faculty driven.
Faculty driven.
Yes. Okay. But that could be interesting. But it's difficult to find too easily, or else you have to be very careful choosing the students. And we choose the students mainly by their ambition and by their grades. We usually tend to choose students with higher grades to this kind of projects because we think that it's more reliable. Okay?
That's a very nice project. Any other question? I just want to advertise a little bit for my presentation. I will present on a global project where we work with three universities around the world to design and manufacture an aircraft with three student teams. If anybody is interested in that as well, we'll basically a continuation of this discussion going on.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay.